My most recent illustration that you can see on my screen reminded me that I wanted to record a video about this topic for a while. So my main question is it still worth investing time in doing illustration painstakingly by hand, or we can just rely on generative AI to create amazing illustrations for us? Now, if you've been following my channel, you know that I have a background in graphic design and illustration, and I've been doing this for over 20 years. So obviously, I am passionate about it. And I'm not outright against using generative AI. I am actually excited always to experiment with it and see what I can use it for. But in this particular video, I want to really just test and compare the results that I can achieve drawing things by hand compared to the results that I can get by generating images using tools like Midjourney or Adobe Firefly. Now, for those who are not familiar with this character, this is supposed to be Sun Wukong, a stylized version of Monkey King, who is a character that really became popular now thanks to the game Black Myth Wukong. But it is a Chinese mythological character that has a long history, particularly from the Journey to the West book. But yeah, so we have some examples here from the most recent game, some concept art as well. It's a really fun character. I had a lot of fun playing this game, and that what inspired me to create this stylized vector illustration. You can see my sketch on the left, which I did in Procreate after a couple of attempts. And then you can see I tweaked a couple of things in the final vector format. I have extended the staff. It turned out to be too small. I also made sure that it's resting on the shoulder because that's an important part of this stance. And I also reduced the length of the beard. I felt like it was a little bit too long. Originally in the sketch, I thought it's going to help to create a bit more curved and dynamic result, but it just got in the way and we couldn't see the body properly. And then I created a couple of color versions, like always here in Illustrator. Once you have your objects in place, it's very quick and easy to do this. And just to be clear, I didn't use any generative AI to create this. And it's actually a very simple illustration, so I am just going to show you the outlines. Not that many objects, and I didn't even do any shading here or texture. It's just a very simple, minimal vector art. But in general, I'm quite happy about my fan art or rendition of this character, and I can imagine the same style working for many of the other characters from the story. But now it's time to take a look at a couple of examples what can be generated using simple prompts. So for instance, here I used Sun Wukong, Monkey King, vector illustration. In this case, I wanted a lotus pose, so meditation and having white background. Now this is on Adobe Firefly using the Firefly Image 3 model, which is currently Adobe's most advanced image model. So let's just do another generate on this and we can see the results. And by the way, here I am using a style reference, my actual image that I created. So I uploaded it and I wanted to see whether it can beat my illustration. But if I remove this style reference, so I'm not going to force it to create similar illustrations, then let's just see what we will get. Now these obviously are completely different illustration styles, but you can argue that they are more detailed and maybe more accurate. However, there's just no appeal to them in my opinion. Now, I'm not saying my illustration is better, but it definitely has a more distinct visual direction. Here is just all over the place. There's influences from lots of different things. And that's generally an issue with generated images, that it's going to reference too many things at the same time and it won't have a clear direction or style. Now, if I go and maybe change something here, maybe instead of lotus pose, we are just going to remove that. And let's see what happens. So I'm restricting even less in my prompt. And now we are getting slightly more interesting results. So this is just a head. It's not bad. Again, different version on the portrait. Another one and one more. Now, if I want the Monkey King to be fighting, Sun Wukong, Monkey King fighting and maybe holding his staff. Let's see if we get a little bit more of an action pose here. So we are getting something more similar to the pose that I had there. Again, the style is a bit all over the place. There's just too much unnecessary detail. And more importantly, it's just not getting that appeal of the character that I feel like I managed to capture quite well. Now, if we jump over to Midjourney, and especially when we use the Niji image model, which is specifically was created for illustrations, this obviously is going to give us much better results, because compared to Adobe, Midjourney is not setting any limits on what they are using for training their image models. So they are scraping everything that they can get their hands on. And that, of course, achieves better results. So we can see lots of cool illustration styles here. I wouldn't say that any of these in particular look like vector illustrations. Maybe this one could be a vector illustration. Maybe some of these could be done in vector illustration format, but they are again very different from the style that I had in mind. I quite like this one as well though. And although it is a cool thing that we can create images like these from a single text prompt, and we can come up with hundreds or thousands of variations, it is very hard to give judgment on the quality of these illustrations or the worth or merit of these illustrations. Because even though I specified the prompt that you can see on the top right corner, it's not something that I can consider created by me. It was created by the machine. So just to be clear on the wording, it's generated, not created. Now, someone, of course, can use these generated images as inspiration. So before starting an illustration project, just like doing your research on other sites like Pinterest, Instagram, Dribbble, or Behance, you can come to sites like Midjourney or Adobe Firefly and generate a couple of illustrations just to get some ideas from them, and then start your creative process, whether it's on paper or digital. Now, jumping back to Adobe Illustrator, I also wanted to show the vector image model, because we have the generate vectors option here directly within Illustrator. And again, I used a simple prompt and I used a style reference, my illustration for the top row of illustrations. And these were without a style reference that you can see at the bottom. And these are all vector illustrations, so they are vector outlines, and that means obviously we can scale them up as much as we want. They are resolution independent. And again, they have lots of detail in them, but there's obviously a lot of issues and just messy in general. So they lack clarity, they lack, again, visual appeal, visual direction. There's just nothing really to them that would make me want to choose these over these illustrations. So going back to the question, whether I can beat and be better at creating illustrations compared to generative models like Midjourney and Adobe Firefly, I feel like at the moment, I still get better results doing things by hand. I am completely in control and I can tweak every little detail until I am 100% happy with what I wanted to achieve. Compared to this, generating images is not much different from just browsing through hundreds or thousands of images. You will see always interesting things, but you will never see exactly all those ideas together that you wanted to achieve. And yes, of course, you can combine multiple generated images together to then create your own version. But at that point, you are essentially just doing referencing the same way we've done it before generative AI. So just to be clear, I'm not saying generative AI is worthless for illustration. It can be used for inspiration or coming up with different directions and ideas. But for the actual creation stage, I wouldn't personally advise to use it. If you want to create something unique that has a lot of appeal and a very distinct visual direction. And of course, no one really knows how fast this technology is going to advance, how much better these image generation models will become. But if you ask me, you are better off spending your time learning to draw and learning to create things by hand, because that is a skill no one can take away from you, and it is going to give you the ultimate freedom to express yourself and to create things that you can be proud of. As always, thanks a lot for watching, and I will see you in the next one.